Hello everyone. In the previous lecture, we had seen how the shear stresses are distributed in rectangular section, in circular section, and in triangular section. In today's lecture, we are going to see how the shear stresses are distributed in I section. So we know I section consists top and bottom flange and a web in the center of the section. So as we know, what is the formula for shear stress? Tau equals to S A Y bar upon I into B, where S is the shear force at any section, A Y bar is the moment of the area considered beyond the considered strip, the strip that we take, or the section or the fiber, you can say. So first case, when the strip, or you can say the fiber, strip or the fiber is considered within the flange. So here you can see, we can take the section in flange portion or in web portion. So there will be two cases. Case one will be when fiber is considered within flange, and case two will when strip is considered in the web. Okay, so first of all, we are going to see the first case here. When we are taking the section or the strip EF or the fiber EF in the flange portion at a distance small y from the neutral axis, so this is the area under consideration beyond this EF. Width is B and the thickness will be, because this is Y and total depth is D, so this will be dy2. So the depth of the considered area will be dy2 minus Y. So from here, shear stress within flange at a distance Y from neutral axis. Okay, so Y will vary only within this flange portion. So Y equals to small d by 2 to capital D by 2. Okay, so area of this strip considered will be B. V is the width, the thickness will be d by 2 minus Y, because Y is the distance, d by 2 minus Y. What is the centroid? Y bar. Y bar will be small d by 2, because this is small d by 2, sorry, this is Y. Y plus y bar will be y plus 1 by 2 of d by 2 minus y, because d by 2 minus y is the thickness of this strip. So at the center, the CG will lie at the center. So this will be y plus 1 by 2 of d by 2 minus y. So it will be 1 by 2 d by 2 plus y. When it, you will simplify it. So the shear stress tau. Shear stress tau will be S A Y bar upon I B. S will remain same. A Y bar is B D by 2 minus Y into 1 by 2 Y plus D by 2 upon I. We are keeping it same as it is. Into B is the width of the strip. So this is capital B for the flange. So tau will be S upon 2 I capital D square minus Y D square by 4 minus Y square A square minus B square. So at top edge, because Y varies at y equals to small d by 2 to capital D by 2. At y equals to capital D by 2 means at the top surface or at the top of the flange, tau will be 0. When y, we will put y equal to d by 2, this will be 0, so tau will be 0. At junction within flange, because here you can see y is varying from this portion at the junction of flange and web within the flange, because y will, when we will take y, we will take within the flange. So just d by 2 to small d by 2 to capital D by 2. So at junction within flange, small y d by 2, y equals small d by 2, tau will be s upon 2 I d square by s upon 8 I into d square minus small d square, because 1 by 4 will be taken out, so it will be s upon 8 I. Okay, variation here too, you can see this, the variation is parabolic in nature, but at the junction how the shear stresses are changing, that we have to see. Okay, now this is the first case. Now in the second case that we had seen, when a strip is considered within web, so this is the second case here. We had taken the strip in the web. So EF is considered in the web portion. So area beyond web will be, this is the total area flange, or area of the flange, and as well as the the area of the wave considered. Okay, so we had taken it as A1 and this small area of wave is taken as A2. This is the neutral axis and the distance of the centroid from neutral axis for this A1 area we had taken as y1 bar, and for this small A2 area this we had taken as the y2 bar. Okay, at distance y this we had taken this strip y. So total moment of the area considered AY bar will be A1 into y1 bar plus A2 into y2 bar. So first of all, for this plane the area will be capital B dy2. This is total dy2 minus a small dy2. This is the area of the total flange into the centroid. Centroid will be y1 bar. So it will be dy2 plus half of dy2, capital dy2 minus a small dy2. Half of capital dy2 minus a small dy2. So y1 bar will be half of dy2 plus a small dy2. This is the centroid of this flange. For wave, the area will be small v because the width is small v of the wave. Small v into this thickness or depth, you can say it will be, this is capital D by small d by 2 and this is y, so it will be small d by 2 minus y. This is the area and the centroid will be y2 bar, so y plus half of d by 2 minus y, so it will be 1 by 2 d by 2 plus y, so this will be 1 by 2 d by 2 plus y. After simplifying, this will be a y bar equals to b by 2 d square minus a small d square upon 4 plus a small b by 2 small d square by 4 minus y square. So tau will be s b t square minus small d square upon 4 plus b of b bracket d square by 4 minus y square upon 2 ib. Okay, now here you can see what is the variable. Variable is only small y. So y will vary from, because from neutral axis to this junction of the wave and flange, it we will take the y within the wave. Okay, so at y equals to dy2 at junction within wave, what will be tau? So at dy2 it will be 0, so s will be s upon a tie b upon b to d square minus a small d square, because we are taking it junction in the within wave. At junction within flange, small v will be capital V, so it will be cancelled out. So this result will be 8s upon a tie d square minus a small d square. Here you can see, you can relate it. Okay, so at neutral axis, at y equals to 0, tau will be tau max, that we know at neutral axis shear stress is maximum, so it will be s upon a tie b upon b t square minus a small d square plus s upon a tie into a small d square. So here you can see at junction this is s upon a tie b upon b t square minus a small d square, and at neutral axis this is s upon plus some plus of this value s upon a tie into d square. So maximum value lies at the neutral axis. So how it is drawn, here you can see at top as well as at the bottom the shear stress is 0, at junction shear stress changes and the maximum is at the neutral axis. So variation is parabolic by the function, we can see. So it will be parabolic like this. This will start from 0, it will come to this point where the shear stress is s upon 8 into y d square minus a small d square, this portion, and at this portion it is how much? This is, because this is within flange and within web, the value changes s upon a tie into capital B upon small b d square minus d square, because capital B upon small b is greater than 1, so this value will change by some magnitude at the junction itself. Now the parabolic variation will continue and the maximum value will reach at the neutral axis. This is the neutral axis maximum value and this is tau max, and this will be symmetrical like this because the I section is symmetrical about both the axes. So this is the shear stress distribution for the I section. In exams you may be asked about the variations of any kind of sections that may be I section, that may be H section, that may be rectangular, circular, triangular, any kind of section they may ask in exams. So you don't need, no need to worry about that. You similarly, you have learned the concept, you know the formula SAY bar upon IV. So you have to consider the strip and you have to find the moment of that area beyond the strip about the neutral axis. So same concept will be applied for all the sections. Okay, for any doubt you can ask me anytime. Thank you.